Hi folks, I'm Voba. I'm a singer and a vocal trainer, and this is my channel about anatomical vocal training.
Do-ka-do-a.
Today I want to elaborate a bit about why I don't talk about the diaphragm. Most vocal coaches and singing teachers talk about the diaphragm a lot, and I don't at all, ever. That has a few reasons. Firstly, my definition of support differs from the definition of most other vocal teachers and singers, in that most people say the continuous airflow is the origin of the vocal cord vibration. I say it's not. It can be a factor, and it is a factor, but it's an aesthetic factor, not a necessary one. The origin of the vocal cord action, vibration, is electrical impulses from the brain that tell the muscles to vibrate. Therefore, my definition of support is to retain the air in the lungs rather than to continuously push it out or let it go out. If I want to let it come out, I will, but it's not a necessity in order to make my vocal cords work. That kind of like brings me to a place where I want a more stable container rather than a very flexible container. So that's why I'm using the rib cage and the intercostal muscles in order to open my rib cage and suck my air into the lungs, because the rib cage are bones, right? It's made up out of bones, and bones have a more stable, it's easier to keep them more stable than just muscles, right? If you want to keep just muscles stable, it's more difficult than just having the bones help with that and just using bones and muscles together. The next reason why I don't focus on the diaphragm is that I want it to be flexible to give me a nice vibrato. Now, if I put too much focus on the diaphragm, I might put too much stress on it to hold it like this or to push like that. I just want it to be flexible so I can have a nice vibrato with that muscle. That really helps. And also I see that focusing on the diaphragm has a tendency to create tension in people. And as a singer, I want to avoid tension. I want to innervate the muscles, I want to work the muscles, but I don't want any muscle tension. And it's easier to not get into muscle tension with these big intercostal muscles that you can actually feel outside with your hands, rather than something that you can just feel inside, or maybe the intestines, how they push out when the diaphragm pushes down. So I saw a tendency that people that use the diaphragm, they have a tendency to either push or get into some kind of tension. And we don't need that, even for like consonants. You know, you don't need your diaphragm to have explosive consonants. And one very important reason why I don't talk about the diaphragm as well is that you will use it anyhow. This is the rib cage with the diaphragm inside. The diaphragm starts, is attached actually to your rib cage, down here in front and in the back as well. And it kind of like curves up into your belly, into your upper torso. Now, when you open your rib cage, the lower ends of your ribs, they open, right? They open to the side. Now, what happens to that diaphragm when this opens? Of course, it is pulled kind of like straight, right? Because the distance between these two lower points increases. So the diaphragm is pulled down anyway. So even if I don't talk about the diaphragm, you already use it when opening your ribs for breathing. It is part of the process anyhow. So even though you don't think about it, you will naturally use it. And we use it every day, you know, we breathe every day. So you thinking more about rib cage and how to open the rib cage. Firstly, it's a more graspable feeling. You can more easily grasp it. And secondly, you are using it anyways, just in a very relaxed manner. And it's just going to do whatever it needs to do. And it knows what it needs to do because you breathe every day. So that's why I'm not talking about the diaphragm that much at all. I hope that gave you a few nice inputs and things to think about, maybe a different perspective. And I will see you when I see you. And of course, you can always subscribe to my channel and like the video if you like the content, or dislike it if you don't. And have a wonderful, beautiful day.